Has pledged to focus on building the capacity of local industries and strengthen the public private sector during his regime. This was during a ceremony in which Francis Mwebaza was handed to office by his predecessor Amelia Chambade in Kampala today.
We must make our Chamber of Commerce strong, and I want to tell you, I will try my best with my age and everything, because I know how a Chamber of Commerce runs. Let's stop this business.
As Uganda aspires to enter the middle income status, the new Minister of Trade has pledged to put the interests of the private sector and Ugandans as he executes his mandate. Mwebaza said there is an urgent need to strengthen the Chamber of Commerce as an advocate and framer of private sector-led policies.
The Chamber of Commerce is the body which looks after a nation's trade. Belongs to Bajaj, belongs to who? The players are the traders themselves. They make government policy. They write the cabinet papers. It is not somebody sitting on the side there and saying this. And in Uganda here, what has happened is anarchy. Everybody starts his trade. In Imbarara, we have people who claim to be the richest people. They sit every week. They are now on my telephone that they have put me in their group. You see, it must be, the people must vote from all over the country and have a Chamber of Commerce in every town. And that Chamber of Commerce in every town must be supervised by us, the ministry, and make sure that you come and have a central body here, so that these are the people who have been government and them.
He said lack of a strong chamber in Uganda has led to uninformed policies passed in the deterrent of the private sector, like it was the case when several businesses closed to contain spread of COVID-19.
When we went into a meeting of ministers, I couldn't believe it. I know it is necessary that we stop all that sort of thing, but they should have been given a chance. And at the same time, there were other things to be done. You could have cleared those people on the street who have nothing to do.
As much as we are struggling for health, COVID is not going to go away tomorrow. For example, the wholesalers. When we close the wholesalers, this is the heart of the entire country and the region.
Former State Minister of Trade Mike Wehe made remarks that signaled infighting between different ministries over the same role of the industry.
Now, industries. Honorable Bahati, this is the domicile of the industrial policy. But as you settle in, you will discover that there are attempts to plug off some of our rights and responsibilities by other ministries, especially, I don't want to mention the ministries, but you know. So you must really have your foot stamped down, because at the end of the day, His Excellency the President, the appointing authority, will look at you.
And industry, it's safety to operate within the critical time of the 42 lockdown in managing COVID.
Currently, industrial parks are developed and managed by Uganda Investment Authority, whose board reports to the State Minister of Investment and Prioritization in the Finance Ministry. They also cited some of the challenges that the ministry has been grappling with. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news in Kampala.
At the onset, we had only